Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your girl Daisy Simo, aka La Daisy. You're now tuned into the LIQ podcast. Bitch, still lit.
You are now tuned into the LIQ podcast.
I don't do tit for tat. You know that this ain't that. Tank, tank, bitch, relax. Get up and go get a bag. I really came up from nothing. I saw, flipped it and turned it to something. They love me cause I'm stunting. I might just go take a flight out to London. Now we pop out in Paris. You gotta pay for appearance. Runway fashion, they staring. I got the maddest apparent. I got them swiping a visa. Getting this chicken like Caesar. Motivation to these bitches. You would think I'm a speaker. I'm getting pounds and it's heavy. I make it rain like confetti. Dripping like water, I'm wetty. Always on guard, stay ready. Keep one eye open like Fetty. I'm moving steady. Say he wanna see more, I told him put me in deal. Put me in deal. I don't do tit for tat. You know that this ain't that. You know that this ain't that. I don't do tit for tat. You know that this ain't that. Tay Tay, bitch, relax. Get up and go get a bag. I really came up from nothing. I saw, flipped it and turned it to something. They love me cause I'm stunting. I might just go take a flight out to London.
You are now tuned into the LIQ podcast.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're now tuned in to the LIQ podcast. You know the thing, you know the vibe. And if you don't know what's going on, we're going to let you know real quick. You feel me? We in the building. How are you feeling? You all right? Everybody good? Yeah? Yeah, got my mans rolling up over there. Pop, you all right? Energy? Hoser, what's up? Talk to me, bro. Yeah, let me feel you real quick. All right, before we get started with the episode, let's run over a few little preliminaries. If you guys want to be on the show, do me a favor, call the hotline. Let me get it up there real quick. 626-209-9402. You can call the hotline, ask us completely anything. And the whole premise of the show is to bring on influencers and allow them to connect with their audience. And we answer every question that comes in. Unless it's like really long and doesn't really have a point, we might like just post it, but you know what I mean? Anyways, make sure you guys hit the YouTube as well. It really helps us monetize this channel where, you know what I mean, to go where we're trying to get where we're trying to go. That's how we say it. Yeah. So, yeah, tap in with us on there. It helps out. Every follow, every like, every comment. We're just trying to build this community one episode at a time. We are here today. You guys seen the treehouse get active, and it's about to get even crazier. Today's guest. Oh, wait. Hold on. We forgot mail time. Hold up. Mail time. Let's hit mail time real quick. This segment is called Mail Time. It's brought to you by Bolt Print Shop. Bolt Print Shop is in the city of New Jersey. Well, no, Union City, New Jersey, actually, to be specific. Yeah, shout out them. We got some mail that came in today, and I'm excited about this one. Shout out the team over at Pro Club. They hooked us up crazy. Look, let me show y'all real quick. Hey, we got a new rug for the studio, y'all. Shit about to really go crazy. Yeah, Brian, shout out Brian, man. I appreciate you 1,000%. The team is crazy. What they got going on is exciting. And I'm excited to be able to, like, you know what I mean, partner with them and work with them in the future. There's a lot of exciting things that's happening through podcasting. You know what I mean? And I love it. We're in a very exciting place right now. So, yeah, without further ado, let's get into this episode. Today's guest is from Southern California. In 2021, she was an opening act for J.I.'s The Young and Restless Tour. She just dropped the video. She's going crazy on the internet right now. You feel me? Keep a close eye on her because I feel like she's about to go crazy. A lot of people that have come through the pod after we had them, they just go crazy on the net. Storm DeBarge is a perfect example of that. She started doing like Super Bowl shit. You know what I mean? I'm excited to have you. We're in the beginning of stages of what's going on right now. Ladies and gentlemen, help me give a big hand for Daisy Simone. Let's go.
Hey.
Ooh, hold up. What's going on, baby girl? How you feeling?
Yo, I'm feeling great. I'm feeling lit. I'm feeling cool.
What was you on today?
I mean, woke up, still lit from last night, got some food, Chick-fil-A, and baby, now I'm here.
For real. Thank God it wasn't Sunday. You ever want Chick-fil-A like on a Sunday?
Every Sunday.
Yeah, and be really mad it's not there?
Every Sunday.
Yeah,
super
that's
mad.
Crazy. What was you on last night?
I went to the studio, then ended up at the club. So,
for what club did you go to?
Hyde. I went to Hyde.
Oh, you went to Hyde?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
It was a little crazy.
You rock with Hyde though? I went to Warwick the other night, and I got home at 5 a.m.
I got crazy home hurt. Like 4. But I mean, it's cool. It's calm. It's not. Yeah. I went in slides, so.
Oh, for
I went
real?
In studio. No, there are foam.
You're
foam
one of
runners.
Those, like, I'm at the club, but I'm just me. Like, no, you feel me? You're
studio.
Not. You're not doing the dress shit.
No, no. Yeah. I mean, you know, I'm at bitch point blank. Period. But
yeah.
No, I was in the studio, so it was like cozy wear. There are foam runners, so.
Yeah. See, so it was on play. Me. Hey, have you ever been to like any of the Hollywood like after hours?
No.
Like the warehouse parties or like
no.
End up at a random mansion that's like a party?
The way I lay or is like, right now, I'm yeah. Like, oh, I'm scared.
Why? What are you scared about?
It gets a little active.
Oh, for real?
Yes.
The boom, boom, like, bang, bang.
The boom, yeah, boom, but, Chief Keith, bang, bang.
Yeah, but you're like a female. You're not going to get clapped at.
I mean, those bullets don't have
you might
a...
get clapped. You might not get clapped. Hey, yeah. You feel me? There's difference.
Ding dong.
Yeah. Yeah, that's Hollywood, though.
It
you
is.
You know what I'm saying?
It's L.A.
I feel like that's the cool. Guys got to worry about Hollywood more than the girls. Or L.A., period.
No, but they've been getting the girls, too. They've been robbing them and stuff. So I'm like...
For real? You seen videos of that shit already?
Yes.
That's crazy.
But no negative energy.
Hey, how's your process in the studio? Like, what did you... did you record something? Did you do just have, like, a writing session or...
Well, I just vibed out a little bit. You know, like, I was there just hearing some beats and stuff. And then I went live for my release for London.
Yeah.
So I was just catching a vibe. That's usually how it always goes. Like, I'll hear some beats. If I catch something, I'll just do it. If not, then I don't, like, force the vibe.
So. But yesterday was drop day, so you were excited
but
to pull that trigger.
Was, yo, and for the real? Trigger was pulled.
That's fire. So, yeah, let's talk about London real quick. We'll go back and talk a little bit about, you know, your come up. But let's talk about what's popping right now. London came out. Let's talk about it. The visuals are here. What's special about it for you? Let's hear about all that.
So when I first heard the beat, it sounded like a UK drill beat. That's always how it is. If I hear a guitar or something, I'm like, oh, this could be gospel. Like, I'll do gospel. So I was like, you know what? Like, let me get on my British ting, fucking mental, bruv. And I was like, you know
mean.
What?
Yeah,
you know
mean.
What I mean? Ain't it, bruv? Ain't I like my bruvs from the ends. Yeah. Like,
hey, yo, look at that mup over there. Yo, you know what I mean?
Mup, taking a piss. Yeah.
I'm a bit peckish. That's like the little, like, lingos, you feel me? Yeah, one of my best friends, he's like a UK dude.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I always wanted to go
shout
to
out, whoa. For real?
Yes.
You never been in London?
No. Nando. I'm manifesting it. I was supposed to go, but I'm dog sitting, so I'm like.
sacrifice for the dog, for real?
Sacrifice for the dog.
Are you one of those girls that like buys their dogs like Christmas cards and shit?
Well, I'm planning to throw him a party. He's a Gemini. His birthday. June 6th, save the date. Pluto's going viral.
I tried to have my dog a birthday party. I just forgot about his whole birthday. Like, I was a horrible owner. Like,
that's
that shit crazy.
You don't think they know, but he felt that.
Yeah, but he said dogs are like the most loyal thing, so you can be disrespectful low key. Not that you're supposed to like.
That's
push
like a
line.
Man type of mentality, huh?
For real, like he gonna hold me down. Like.
This bitch finna be loyal, so it's okay. Yeah. You can just fuck around. I hate y'all.
For real, right? Like, that shit crazy. Where were you born? What city?
Born and
where
raised.
Where did we go to high school? What did we do all that?
Well, I was born
when
and
did
raised.
We become a brat? You feel me?
Oh, brat.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
I was
start.
Born. I came out the womb a brat, you know? But no, I was born and raised Rancho Mirage, which is Coachella Valley.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. And then where I grew up, it's like 2 minutes from the festival.
Right.
So I would always like do that. But there's no rappers over there. It's just like old money, retirement, things like that. So I'm like the first person to do music out there.
Yeah, that's far.
Yeah, Indio High School. I'm like, damn.
Oh, Indio High School?
Indio High
that's
School.
Crazy.
We're the home of the Cholas and the Cholos and the A-Fools. Like,
yeah, I feel like when you hear Indio, you kind of know what it is.
Indio
you know
High
the
School.
Vibras. You feel me?
Yeah, I don't
you
know what it is.
That's crazy. So you're fully fluent, right, in Spanish and all that good stuff.
Wonderful.
I was listening to your catalog you have on Spotify today, and I heard the little Spanish rap in there. Like, you came in the game like that, or you added that later on?
Yeah, that was always something that I always wanted to do, but only like 8 bars, just to like a hint of Spanish, you know? Because even if you don't speak Spanish, you're gonna be like, oh shit, but it's so quick that you hear it and it grabs you and you don't lose interest.
Yeah,
you
just trying to tease him with it a little bit.
A little bit, you know, Mexicana. Latina.
That's fire. And then are you signed to a label or anything like that? Or I know you have a team with you, like management and stuff like that, but are you signed to anybody right now?
No, I'm still like independent.
Word. Yeah. And so at what point did you decide to get like managers involved and different things like that? Like, when did you realize like, all right, I kind of need to get serious about this?
So I just dropped one song and I saw that like people really liked it, and then I did a snippet on Instagram and it kind of like took off a little bit, and that's where my manager found me and DM'd me, and I was like, let me see. And I got on the phone and I was like, I mean, because I'm from Coachella, no one does anything like that out there. So I was like, is this real? Like, oh, whatever. It's kind of like, I just
and
threw
it's
it
not
out
all
there.
Palabra.
Like, and it's not. Yeah, so I was like, let me see. And then I flew out to New York, and then the rest is history. Now I'm on the LIQ podcast.
You're getting it in. Yeah. So how long have you actually been rapping?
Like a little over a year.
A
like
year?
A year and a half.
Yeah. And like shit's really going crazy already?
Yeah, it's going crazy. I mean, I just did tour, so I was like, damn.
Yeah. Okay. How was that like? Did you have any like prior experience to being on stage, or was that your first time in front of a crowd?
No, never. That was my first time. I was so nervous. And I remember J.I., like, he came out and he was like, oh my God, you're going to do good. And like, I was just so nervous because imagine like performing in front of a bunch of people, sold out show, Philly, and I just went out there sweating bullets. Yeah. I blacked out. I don't even remember, but apparently I killed it. So,
hey, what's tight about the East Coast though, Philly too? Like the energy when they feel the music, they move.
Yeah,
I feel like in LA, there's a lot of cool people. It's harder to move LA than it is like the East Coast people. Like they just move a lot more.
No, what's crazy? Yeah. They were telling me it was the opposite. New York, they're the type, they'll buy a ticket for your show just to hate on you, just to sit back and be
for
like,
for real?
Yeah.
That's not my experience.
The New York crowd was a little tough. Like they were still like bopping and grooving, but all the other cities, they were going like crazy. Yeah. So.
What was your favorite city?
I'm gonna get in trouble, but
why?
My favorite city would probably have to be.
You're gonna
be,
get in trouble for speaking your truth. Just talk.
I mean,
it all was, the other cities got to step it up.
Like, you know what? Washington D.C. Random. They were super lit, like super, super lit. Like I just peeked out and then like Daisy. I'm all damn. What the hell? Okay, period.
That's fire.
Probably Washington and Seattle. That was super, super dope.
Hey, you have you been keeping up with Kim and Pete Davidson?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'll be honest. Yes.
How do you feel about it?
I want Kim Ye back together. That's how I feel. Yes, Kim Ye.
Hey, have you saw the documentary?
Yes.
That's why too,
yes.
Huh?
No.
I feel like it's hard to hate Kanye though. As much as you want to hate him, you gotta love him.
I get him, and I feel I honestly feel like he's a genius. Like I genuinely do. Like I don't even see him as like a rapper. I see him like an Elon Musk type of vibe. Yeah. Like he's very. Very out of this
isn't
world.
It crazy though to see somebody's life just lived out loud in front of everybody?
Yeah, the fact that he was like recording and documenting everything. What?
Early though.
What?
Yeah.
She couldn't afford a car, so on the name of daughter Alexis. Like, how do you hear that? And you're just like,
it's cool.
Like, what? Yeah. I would have been like, oh shit, but
that's crazy.
It was crazy.
Yeah, but what, like, let's say, right, you get as big as Kanye doing this music shit, right? Mm-hmm. And like, you go from just being recorded every day, being documented, all that stuff, like, and to where you're at now, and then you get in a relationship, and your relationship is being looked through a magnifying glass. Imagine being in that position, though.
Right. But you know what's crazy? I think Kim really is a writer, because, like, the whole red cap and everything, I feel like she was trying to hold it down, but she probably just, like, got tired of it. I don't know. But Kim Ye, please.
For real. That's
like,
crazy.
For the culture. It's like Kim and Kanye, they, you know. But, I mean, hey, Pete.
Hey, Pete. What's up? Hey, you think they'll get back together or no, though? I know you want them to, but you think they will?
Maybe. I don't know. I just... Okay, this that's like Julia Fox. Maybe. Yeah.
No. That's funny.
I don't know.
That's hilarious. Hey, but like, how you say this? Like, that I feel like this is like, if they do get back together... This is one of the craziest publicity stunts ever. Like
100%.
That,
but I don't feel like it is because he always has like breakdowns throughout. Yeah, and I feel like this is just an
but
episode.
I feel like with the documentary, I feel like you kind of understood the breakdowns.
You
like
can't
you
hate under- on him.
Like you understand why he's breaking down because you've seen him like go through each level and like
And his mom, yeah. His mom was so sweet. I mean, R.I.P. Donda, but yeah, I mean, I understand him. He's a genius. You know, he goes through breakdowns, everything. He's human at the end of the day. I always see like celebrities and stuff like that. I try not to idolize them or anything because it's like they just got successful on their passion.
What have you taken from it so far?
100%. Just to keep on going. Because, I mean, he's the biggest thing. He influenced everybody and everyone's like, oh, no, like stick to making beats. Like, oh, no. It just took like that one chance. So you really never know what you can make.
You
got to
get it. Hey, I like your style of rap. It's like aggressive rap. I feel like you're an alpha female.
100%.
For real?
Yes.
Hey, when you get a man, you like dominant.
Oh my God.
You be choking him out.
Oh my
God. For real. I feel like you're an alpha female for real. Just off of your vibes, your music. You feel me? Like,
yeah, I'm just very,
you know what I'm
like,
saying? I'm that bitch.
Alpha.
What's up?
Yeah. And all my friends, I mean, I just have my friend here, shout out Karina, and my sister. Those are like my only two girlfriends and Stephanie. The rest are all guys, and they're telling me like, damn, you're single? Yeah, they're like, you're single?
You're the girl that has a bunch of guy friends?
Oh my God, fuck the stigma.
That's
you know,
crazy.
No, it's because, I don't know, I'm just like, I'm the only female on the G-Star, so it's just me and like a bunch of my bros and stuff, so they're like, you're too aggressive, you're never going to find a man like that, and I was like, I don't need to find one, they're everywhere. I can get one, but they just can't handle. I don't know.
Yeah,
like,
but that's what I'm saying. When you actually find a man that can handle you, that's how you know that's the one. He can handle you.
It's tough.
It's like a horse. You feel me? If you can't ride the horse, you're going to fall off.
Well, I am a stallion, but a horse.
You get what I'm saying? Like, if you can't ride the ride, you got to get off the ride. Like,
right.
Yeah, for real.
And I feel like men get intimidated by, like, strong females. Like, yeah. Because I'm a rapper.
Has anybody fumbled trying to approach you?
I mean, because I'm nice. I'm not going to be like a bitch, but I'll just give you like maybe not a fake number, but like I'll just say
fake numbers.
No, I'll just be like, oh, I have a boyfriend. And then they'll be like, really? And I'm like, yeah, he like kills people. I'm like, oh, it's fine. Or I'll be like, oh, yeah, he's Jamaican.
I feel like every guy thinks when a girl says that they're lying. Like they're just like trying to.
Ignore. Yeah, I only said that like one time because I feel like it's kind of corny sometimes. But I don't know. Like, or I'll just be like, I really just don't want to talk to you. So. Sorry.
Yeah, for real.
Like, I don't, you know.
You be breaking hearts. Energy. What about the DMs? The DMs be going crazy.
What? Do I look like a crip? These blue check marks. Yeah. No, the DMs be looking crazy. I'm not going to lie. But I don't answer them. I mean, I already know what these guys like. Again, like being in the industry and everything like that, like rapping, like I know how they move. So I'm good.
Yeah. But like, this is the thing, though. This is the confusing part for the internet. This is what I feel like, right? The girls is out there in the front. You know what I'm saying? You're popping on the internet. You're getting guys to be like, ooh, ah, click, double tap. You know what I mean? All this good stuff. And then, like, not you, but, like, maybe some females, if you hit them up, they're, like, they kind of, like, rude or, like, kind of, like, like, oh, my God, watch out or whatever. But it's like, yo, you're, like, opening yourself up. Like,
right.
You feel me? What you're giving out and what you're giving out are two different things.
Like, yeah, I feel like it just depends, like, if they say something like, oh, your music's fire, I'll just be like, oh, thank you. Yeah. Like, I'm not going to be
a
bitch.
Are you quick
bitch,
to call a guy bro? All right, bro. That's how you put him in his zone real
quick. I hit him with the gang.
Gang.
I hit him with the gang.
Yeah,
I'll be like, gang, gang. I'll be like, yo, bro. Oh, yeah, I know. Shout out gang.
That's
and then
crazy.
I feel like they're like, oh, yeah. And then and they're like.
Yeah. Hey, is it true with females, you know, in the first 5 seconds if you like a guy or not?
100%. I feel like that's true for guys too.
Yeah.
Off conversation and energy and stuff. Yes, 100%.
Nobody's ever grown on you?
No, I don't stick along. Like, I don't stick around for that long.
Oh, for real?
What?
You're in and out. You're bobbing and weaving through these dudes. That's crazy. You're breaking hearts out here.
No, because my type of guy, like, I like when they're in the cut and you feel like the boss energy, they don't have to tell you. The loudest in the room to me is the weakest and corniest. Like, they'll be like, oh, like if you really have it, you don't have to talk about it. You know, like you just have it. So that's my type of vibe. But.
That's crazy. That's why Rosecrans ain't said a word yet.
Oh!
He's on his boss shit right now.
That's gang.
Yeah, he's on gang shit right now. You feel the aura. Hey, you gotta talk, bro.
Shout out Rosecrans.
Yeah. I'm gonna start whispering, you know what I mean? So I, you know what I mean? It'll be the quietest.
Don't come
in the room.
To LA.
Yeah, for real. It's getting active out here. How did you link with Rosecrans?
On Instagram, right?
Yeah.
We met on Instagram. Yeah, and then I followed him because, I mean, he was funny and stuff like that. And I seen he obviously is Mexican and stuff, and I support my Latinos.
Yeah.
But he was cool and everything. His podcast was fire. So I was like, yeah. And then I invited him. No. He was a real one because when I posted the tour, he's like, I'm there. And you know how most people like will be like, put me on the list. He buy his ticket, everything. Yeah. I was like, damn. Like,
yeah, you got to show support.
100%.
A lot of people, I mean, sometimes I ain't going to hold you. I'll be like, yeah, throw me on that list. But sometimes, you know what I mean? When you see people really like putting in on themselves, you got to show the support.
Right.
Like, it's more of like, yo, I got your back. You
that's
feel
real,
me?
That's real because everyone would just hit me up. They'll be like, oh, they'll put eyes.
Put me on
they'll
a list.
Like, yeah, they'll
list.
Be like, oh, yo, that's lit. Yeah. Where?
If you see me, put me on a list.
Right. I'm shitty
yeah.
too, but.
Me and the squad, we going up.
That's yeah. what I'm saying. He's real because I would be, yeah. put me on the list, bitch.
Yeah, for real. I ain't trying to walk it. No lies right now.
Yeah.
That's fire. But even to have like a stamp like Rosecrans behind you, it says a lot about you as an artist. There's a lot right. of big things that, you know, I mean, that he co-signs, and the fact that like we're here today because of that, because like of, I yeah. think it's fire. That's why I really was in, like interested to see what is it about you, but your personality is loud and thank I love you. It. It's good vibes.
Thank you. Yeah, you never want to force nothing. And it was crazy how we do line up yeah. with everything. So that's how I know I'm like on a good path because I'm blessed. Like he's dope to have in my corner. Just knowing I have him, I'm like, we're good.
And that's tight that your talent is able to put people around you and build something.
It's crazy.
That's tight.
Literally, like in my last song on London,
you believe
I said,
in Jesus?
100%.
Yeah, they said your gift and talents will put you before big people.
No, that's and tight. I had this like rebirth or whatever in Joshua Tree. And my passage was something like, it was like a psychic or something. She was telling me, she's like, oh, before you were like born and everything, Jesus put like the voice of warriors or something. And I told her, I was like, oh, I do music.
Yeah.
She's like, that's crazy. I was like, damn.
You're like, yeah, I just killed the bitch on the trash.
I was like,
week.
I mean, I don't do no raw. Gospel. I'm yeah. like, you know, it gets happen.
That's crazy. Where we at? I bet. You have anything else to touch on? Like, how did you grow up real quick? You got brothers and sisters?
Yeah.
Like, what made you aggressive? Like, you feel me? Boy, hold on. I got a 3-year-old right now, and she's aggressive as hell.
What's her sign?
I don't know.
I'm such a sign-ass bitch.
Yeah, I don't know. But my thing is this, like, she's aggressive right now. And I like it because I feel like you get to cut half the bullshit out in life.
Yeah.
Like, you know, being a girl, you won't get taken advantage of
100%.
As much. You feel me?
Yeah.
But, like, what made you aggressive?
Probably because I've been like very independent. My dad's very like, never baby me, never giving me $5. When I was like 10, he'll be like,
putting pops on blast real quick.
Yes. And he's a Capricorn. He's like Mr. Krabs. Yeah. Like he's super about his money.
Yeah.
So, probably just like seeing him and he'll just be like, don't be a freeloader. I'm like, damn, I'm 9. Yeah. What do you mean? I can't work right now. Like, you know, so
that's tight.
Probably that my dad for
you're
sure.
Strict. You got brothers and sisters?
Yeah, it's 3 sisters with my mom and my dad, and then my dad has like 3 kids with his previous wife, and that's 1 brother and 2 sisters.
Damn, so y'all
like 6.
Y'all,
Mexican shit.
And then you're the baby oldest.
I'm the middle.
The middle child.
Yeah.
Damn.
23, and then my little sister's 11, so.
You and your sisters like beef, like you like click up in twos on one sister?
Well, I have one sister, Jasmine. Yeah. We're kind of like
who's like gang? You know what I mean? Like
she,
when it goes down.
People think
like,
we're like her. Yeah. People think we're twins because she's August 28th. I'm August 30th, but she's a year older. So the 29th, we wild out. Like where you see me, you see her and vice versa.
That's
like,
fire.
So.
Yeah, that's tight. So growing up, the house was always active and busy. There's a lot of you guys.
Yeah, super crazy.
That's lit.
The parties are wild, but.
You a party animal?
No, like the family parties.
Oh, word,
one time they broke the closet door.
I was like,
the
damn,
one
we just talk about parties now?
No. The they broke down my closet door to burn, like do a bonfire. Like real Mexican party.
For
family.
Real?
Yes,
like we'll go to Home Depot tomorrow.
No,
go
they
buy
don't even care.
Door.
They just took, I was like,
it's
I want
too
to,
cold right now.
I'm gonna burn. I was like, where's
right
my door?
Now.
Yeah, like, oh, it's burning.
That's crazy. That's hilarious. Yo, one time. Growing up, my daddy used to leave us in the room. He always gave us space, you feel me? But we had these glass sliding doors that were just like, the whole door was a sliding, you know what I mean? Whatever. So my dad had a treadmill in his room. My friends were over. They're running on the treadmill. We sped it up, and the homie just went feet first into the mirror, crashed it. So I just swapped out like the mirror from my room to my dad's. He didn't find out for like 4 or 5 years, bro. Like, I just had to figure it out.
A mirror?
Yeah.
Sheesh, how's his luck?
Yeah.
Because, you know, the seven years of bad luck. I'm like, damn.
Nah, that was like 4 or 5. It was crazy. But yeah. 4 or 5. Burning the door kind of reminded me of that. I don't know why I went left real quick. All right. Okay, yeah. The other question I had. So are you more like Nicki Minaj or more like a Cardi B? And what I mean by that is like, do you got like writers with you or do you write everything yourself?
No, I write everything myself.
So you got the pen on.
100%. Yeah. I've written for some people. Like, that's what I pride myself in.
Is are you ghosting everything out here too?
I mean, sheesh. For real? Your baby father ain't the only one that's ghosting.
All right. That's fire.
Yeah. I mean, I grew up on Nicki, so I like her wordplay, everything. Like, how she's very animated, and I love Cardi's personality. So, I mean, I guess just both of them really did it for me right now. So,
yeah,
Megan too. Funny. Megan's on fire. She's very aggressive too. So, yeah.
Hey, but why at some point when the girls get big, they all start beefing? All coming up, they all support each other. And then when they get big, then it's like, is it the media's fault? Or do you think
I think so, because it's like right now, I feel like there's a lot of girls in rap, but they try to pin it on everybody. They're like, they try to pin each other like, well, Megan and Nicki are like Cardi. And it's so whack because there's so much room, you know? Like,
yeah, for everybody to eat. Yeah.
Because they're trying
to, that sells more.
I mean, I guess so.
All that good shit. All right, let's get into some phone calls. This segment is called Talk to Me Nice. It's brought to you by Earful562 on Instagram, Twitter, and all these other accounts. You need to find them all. Google them if you want. You know what I'm saying? You see my peoples out there holding it down. We got a pop-up coming up 420. Make sure you guys stay tapped in with that. Big information. All right, real quick. Let's see if we can get that split screen. Let's hit them with the first phone call. Let's go.
This is a question for Daisy Simo. What is your most favorite thing about being an artist?
Boom town. All right. Ooh. She wants to know, what's your most favorite thing about being an artist?
That I get paid to do what I love. It's fun. Like, it's a lit. It's just a lit. I have no schedule.
You get to create.
Yeah, I get to create, and then I get to travel. So I'm like, and get paid while doing it. So I'm all purr.
Yeah. Hey. When Rosecrans, look, I ain't gonna hold you. When he first told me about you, I followed you so I could just see what you do. You feel me? And like kind of catch on. So when we brought you in, I could like know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And you didn't drop music for a very long time.
I know.
And then he goes, yo, to have you on, right? I said, yo, my first question is, where the fuck the music at? And then you dropped London.
Who sent you?
Yeah, no, but then you dropped London. Mm-hmm. That's fine. So why was the gap? Why are you making the people wait?
No, it's because I don't know if I'm a Virgo. I don't know, but I'm such a perfectionist that I'm like, I have so many songs in the bank, like banked up. And I'm like, no, I don't want to drop it anymore because I live with it. So like London, I was never going to drop it. Yeah, and but people love it.
Let us live with it.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to feed y'all.
Let us move in. What's up?
Yeah, I'm going to feed y'all. That's get ready to crazy. Nibble.
All right. So now that we dropped, how often do you plan to drop it? You plan to go vacant again and just ride this one out for a year? Like, what's the plan?
Probably like, drop like twice maybe a month. I'll give y'all twice a month.
Two a month?
I'm telling you, I have this fire I could keep supplying. It's just I need to, you know.
That's fire. And quick question. What's the vision?
The vision.
Why be a rapper? Why try to reach the top of the top? Why? Like, what's the vision? What are you doing this for?
I'm doing this to mostly for my family and mostly to have like a fun life. I don't want to look back and be like, oh, my life was so whack. Like, I mean, the whole 9-to-5, it's cool if you love it and stuff like that. I just can't do it. You're an extrovert.
You're here to get it.
I'm here to get it. What? I used to be a bank teller. Maybe I manifested so much money.
Oh, for real?
So, you know. Yeah.
They say if you talk to it, it'll come.
100%. Talk to it. 1,000%.
Real shit. That's fire. The vision is there. What's something that's on your like? What's a goal that you want to touch through music? Like your dream? Like
my goal, my highest goal right now.
Like when you go to sleep and see yourself as an artist, the biggest you could get, like what's that picture? What's biggest, around you like?
The biggest I could get, probably like Kanye, really. Yeah. Bro, you're wearing Yeezys, you know what I'm saying? Like that's crazy. The stem player.
You trying to get
like,
shoes?
I mean, I'm trying to get some it all.
Brat shoes? Imagine a brat deal, you get brat shoes out there.
That's what I'm trying to do.
That should look crazy.
I'm gonna talk it in play, but yeah, just to influence a bunch of people. Like I want to make clothes, everything. Like
Yeah.
I want to do it all. But my right now, my goal, like my biggest goal right now is probably doing Coachella Fest. That's going to be full circle.
Especially because it's hometown.
100%.
Imagine that though, hometown shit.
Sneaking into Coachella Fest, like it's going to be all like.
Yeah.
That's what I used to do when I was in high school.
You were hopping fences and shit.
That's what I used to, Golden Voice, please. Don't arrest me.
You were hopping fences and shit.
Right. Not hopping fences. I would just, they would put a bracelet, you know. Yeah. Damn, I'm giving the sauce, but
it's over now. You don't do it.
It's done. Yeah, but I'll go in, boop, 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 take it up, blah, blah, blah. Then you can't leave. So
yeah, you're just stuck inside.
You're stuck inside.
That's crazy. But. Yeah, that's a little side check, but we'll get it to the next phone call. Let's go. Hold up.
Hey, Daisy, I got a question for you. My name is Ziggy. Would you like to be my friend?
All right, that's my man, Ziggy Ziggler. Hey, shout out Ziggy Ziggler. We just went on a tour. I was in Texas with him. He's my friend. He's on a Ziggy and Friends tour. But he tapped in, and he tapped in with your music, and he fucked with it heavy. So shout out Ziggy for calling in. He wants to know if you could be his friend.
Yeah, amigo.
Yeah.
Gang.
She has a lot of guy friends. Get on board, dog.
Oh,
yeah.
Lord.
Yeah. That's crazy. All right, last phone call. Let's get to it. Let me see where we at. Cool.
Yo, what's good? This is the question right here. It's kind of simple, but it's not. Would you take 50 bands cash, no questions asked, or flip a coin for $2 million? If you lose, you can't keep any of it. Let me know.
All right. Would you flip? Take 50 bands cash right now or flip a coin for $2 million? And if you lose, you can't take nothing. What you doing?
I'm flipping that coin.
For real? You a gambler?
Oh, I mean, you have to take risks to win big. So,
for real.
I mean, 50K, I'll try to work and get the 50K I can. And I could do the 2 million too, but that's 2 million, 50-50. What?
You flipping that coin.
I'm flipping it.
That's crazy. Hey, honestly, though, I'm not a gambler like that.
No?
Nah.
I live life on the edge.
For real.
Yeah. What's look at my shoes. I might break an ankle. Like, what?
You do like any like X game shit, like ride motorcycles?
Yeah, I love ATVing. Yeah, because I'm from the desert. That's all we do. Like we go ATVing.
Oh, for real. That's right.
Just rode a jet ski.
Yeah.
So, you know, I love all that stuff. Roller coasters. Yeah. I'm more Six Flags than Disney type of girl.
Oh, word. That's crazy. That's a good comparison.
Sleeping Beauty can kiss my ass. No, just
hey, you got a man or not?
Nope.
Nah, you open?
I mean, I'm open, I guess.
I bet. The DMs are open, so just let... I mean, people want to know this, you know what I'm saying?
I mean,
you
know
somebody
what?
Watching because they like you, and then they're going to be like, oh,
I'm
word.
Too focused, though.
Like a slide, so you're not tripping on nobody right now?
No. Mm-mm.
So you straight?
I'm 100% single.
Word. Hey, and
this might get me in trouble.
No. But you said you go through relationships fast. How fast are you going through?
No,
them?
Not through relationships. It's just like the talking stage. I know if I'm going to put you.
Out.
Yes, 100%. I'm not going to deal with them.
Do you just leave them hanging or do you let them know?
I'll probably just ghost them.
For real?
I'll start with like, I'll just do one reply.
She's a ghoster. She goes right.
No, I'll do one reply. And then maybe the next day I'll reply. Like, you know, I'm doing like little breadcrumbs, so... And then, poof, I'm gone, Casper.
Poof, you're gone. All right, look, before we get out of here, we got a segment called Dear Internet, right? And this is your last message to everybody listening. If you can face that camera right there, start it with Dear Internet, and this is your message to them.
Dear Internet, this is Daisy Simo. Watch me in a couple months. I'm going to, you know, we about to take off. So shout out LIQ Podcast, for real.
LIQ.
Shout out LIQ Podcast. Dang, tongue tied.
Fire. All right. For more episodes like this, go to leakpodcast.com. Make sure you guys tap in with us. It's an exciting time that we're in. We got the episodes up there. We have, what else? Merch available. We got the links to all of our sponsors. And yeah, man, you know what I mean? Stay tuned. Stand by. I appreciate you pulling up.
I appreciate you for having me.
Yeah. We out of here. Till next time. Peace.